guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So after a very long time, I'm making a vlog. I know I was almost away for a month. I had gone to India to travel and for some business related work as well. So basically now I'm back and had a very good family time there. Now I am in Canada. It's 9 degrees outside. It's quite pleasant here and I am in complete quarantine for 14 days. By the way, the federal government's keeping a check, and that's very good about the whole system because we do need to control the situation as we are again in lockdown. Now, today I'm going to discuss about immigration law as a subject of practice area and how I got into this area and how I love it and practice this particular area of law. And I have somehow tried to restrict myself in this practice area just because of the simple reason that this area itself demands a lot of expertise. And how do you develop expertise is only when you dedicate yourself to one particular field. So basically in Canada, what I've often seen is that lawyers do try to restrict themselves to one practice area. Not everybody wants to do everything just because of the simple reason that if you try and put your hands in everything, you basically spoil everything. So you need to expertise yourself in a particular field and be knowledgeable in that related area of law. Aur usi mein aapko bahut kaam aata hai, aapko aise you don't stress really about yourself. So today I'm going to discuss why immigration law is a full-fledged subject in US as well as in Canada. What are the different fields that branch out from this particular area of law, then how lucrative and how good area of law this is as a lawyer. If you want to see your returns and your pays, how much you can get paid and all of that, and plus as a independent legal practitioner, what are the areas that I particularly expertise in and what is my area of special area of practice. So firstly, I'm going to discuss what immigration law is. Basically, immigration is a field in which it is of growing importance just because of the fact that many people are not Canadians, whereas they are in Canada. So this is for non-Canadians, people who are immigrants who want to come to Canada through different via routes, people who are in Canada and want to make their status permanent, want to go through the process of permanent residency, want to go through the process of getting a Canadian passport, which is quite powerful as a passport itself. So basically, all the related issues related to this particular prominent field and the nexus between immigration law and other fields of law is what immigration field is all about. You will be surprised to know that there are lawyers who specialize in areas of immigration law as well. So supposedly you might know a lawyer who specializes in asylum and refugee cases, because as Canada is a part of UNHRC and is very, very cooperative that way, that Trudeau government and every other government is in support of refugees and asylum seekers in Canada. People who fear persecution in their own country flee to Canada and come through different ways and how they can apply the refugee case, what is the whole process of going through that. So basically some people, even particularly some lawyers, expertise in that non-profit or for-profit government organizations in the immigration field related to refugee and asylum case. Then there are some lawyers who go into the litigation part of it, like for example they deal with appeals, with judicial review applications, with basically anything in which you have been refused a kind of a visa or kind of permanent residency, or there is some kind of discrepancy in your this thing, then you can take it to the Supreme Court of Canada, till the Federal Court of Canada. So basically, some lawyers specialize in that particular area of law. Now, this is all part of immigration law. Then thirdly, I have also seen lawyers who specialize in another area of law, which is much form-based, like the temporary resident visas, and then student applications, then you can say like work permits, LMIE applications. And then there is the fourth category, which is also business migration, which is investment immigration, entrepreneur immigration, people who have money outside Canada and want to invest and get their permanent residency, get their Canadian passports. Then there are big corporates as well who want to intra-company transfer their employees. So basically, all these are fields of immigration law itself. So you can't imagine the kind of diversity immigration law has. Specifically, immigration law in Canada is related to one act, which is Immigration Refugee Protection Act, and the rules therein. So every time there are any developments or anything, the immigration council lawyers, they get together and they are in discussion with the government back and forth with certain, because keeping their clients' interest in mind. So it is itself a very dedicated area of law. So you have a lot of scope in Canada and specifically in US as well when you talk about non-Canadians or non-US citizens. Now the IRCC, which is the Immigration Refugee Council body of Canada and who looks after all the immigration related issues and immigration related applications through which or different embassies wherever you apply across the world for Canadian visas, they take care of it. The IRCC authorizes two kind of people to represent you in their particular forms or in their particular, in your particular case. So for example, one is the RCIC, which are immigration agents, and you might have heard of this term before. RCIC is an immigration course which people usually do and give the licensing exam and get an RCIC number. So either they can represent you at the level, and then there are lawyers, like law lawyers like us, who are regulated by the law societies then and have a particular license number from any law society. So basically immigration is federal, so even if you are an Ontario based lawyer, you can still send somebody to Vancouver, right, depending on the stream. So it does not need to be province based, it's a federal law. Then IRCC will get recognize these two people, and if you are getting represented by any one of them, then you have to give your their number in the forms. Now the only thing that you have to take care of is that the RCIC can actually represent you to a certain stage. They can maybe represent you to basically in you can say till the first stage. Now if your refusal is there or if anything is there, then you have to go to a lawyer, and the RCIC is also going to the lawyer, because then the court is involved. You have to go for judicial review, you have to go for appeal, you have to go for any kind of prominent step that you have to take regarding your case. And believe you me, every day if you open the Federal Court of Canada website, every day there is a case against the immigration and the immigration citizenship bodies, like the other party. So there are multiple cases because people are rejected. Sometimes immigration officers make mistakes and people are rejected on the basis of small errors, which only lawyers maybe are able to rectify and take the matter to the appeal or the Federal Court review stage. Now, I have particularly seen that in refugee or asylum cases, or in, you can say, in any case where there is a rejection of visa and there are guidelines authorized to it, then the immigration officers are basically the admin part. So IRCC is basically an administrative body. The government has given them the authority. That is why the administrative law in Canada is very strong, and immigration law is one of the part of administrative law. So if you study in your NCAs or in your law exams or anywhere, the administrative or the delegation part, then you have to keep in mind that the first organization you're going to study about is the IRCC, because they are one of the very independent bodies in Canada, just like the CRA, the Revenue Agency, and the immigration body. So I tend to tell my clients as well, and tend to tell everybody I know, and that because I do immigration law, and I tend to tell them that your first step has to be very careful. So basically, if you are supposedly in your refugee case or in your any other case, your first step or the basis of claim goes wrong, then your whole testimony till the end will not corroborate with that first particular stage. So you have to be very sure of what you are going through this whole process. And big corporates, big business immigrants, they do need to be very careful with all the frauds that are going on. So this is one of the industry in which a lot of fraud. Now I've recently gone to India and I've heard few cases, and they were like very shocking for me, because I was surprised that people are putting all their savings just to go to Canada, just to come and step here, just to, you know, get any kind of visa, and still people in back home, some foul play is going on, and they are just taking everybody's money so easily and trying to exploit people. Now there are fraud and all these related issues related to this field, so we have to be very, very careful. As a lawyer, I always promote transparency, and I think any of you who interest this area of law should know that the basic thing that you have to keep with the client is basically the transparent and the candid relationship. Not every client can come under every stream. There are certain kind of skilled people who can come under the skilled stream, or the highly skilled, or maybe some province can call you on a demand skill. Some province can nominate you on the basis of other, but not every client would fit into a particular stream. So you have to strategize. How will you get that client permanent residency? How are you going to settle it till the citizenship? How are you going to take care of the whole process? And what are you going to do so that you remain in the ambit of law and still try to get the best possible solution for your client? Now, I have often come across even some lawyers telling us that immigration is not itself a, you know, area of law, but that is so wrong. That's like the thought process in our own countries, but it's not here. Here, it is a full-fledged and a detailed work, and in fact, it is one of the upcoming areas of law, because Canada is a very immigrant-friendly country, and across the world, even from Middle East, I have clients from India, I have clients from Pakistan, I have clients from all across you can think of, and I know that this area of diversified practice really needs more lawyers, more people who can actually go deep, research about it, strategize for a client and get to a particular solution, and be very candid and transparent with the client. So if you want something and you can't get that person through a particular stream, you have to tell them. You have to maybe maneuver the law in the way like we do it in other fields, like in civil, like in criminal, like in any other field. Similarly, remaining with the IRPA Act, complying with the Act and going through the guidelines, going through the rules, regularly keeping in touch with the ESDC officers, regularly, you know, participating in all the summits, knowing what's happening with the Immigration Department, knowing when the what kind of policies internally they are following, knowing what kind of information that they have access to, going through that all that research books like in any other law. In fact, you can also go through the LexisNexis subscription of immigration law, and they have beautiful, beautiful articles coming every day, updating the lawyers about everything. That's the beauty of this particular field of law. Now, I really understand it as money part is very important, and I do understand, because we have done a lot of struggle, come here all the way. All of us appreciate that money is an important part of this factor, and we need the ROI basically. So I can also suggest to you that this is a lucrative field of law. You will not regret in this particular field of law if you actually tend to specialize. If you do it like any other person or any other thing, then there are a lot many people who are doing it. But you have to stand out, like in some particular thing you need to aapne apne aapko different thoda sa karna hai. Agar aap wo nahi kar paoge, to what is the point that somebody is going to hire you for the services, right? Somebody might as well hire a firm like Green and Spiegel, somebody might. But aapka ek jo connection banta hai aapke apne logon ke saath, aapke aap jo jaisi tarike ki aap dealing karte ho, wo sari cheez aur aapki jaisi knowledge hoti hai, jaisa aapka experience padta hai waise aapki knowledge hoti hai. तो वो सारी चीज़ जो है आपको तभी समझ आती है व्हेन यू गेट इनटू दिस फील्ड ऑफ लॉ. सो आई रियली से दैट दिस इज अ लुक्रेटिव फील्ड ऑफ लॉ. इसका रिटर्न भी अच्छा है, इसका सब कुछ अच्छा है. इट्स अ फुल फ्लेज्ड इनफैक्ट एरिया ऑफ लॉ इन विच आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन द पास्ट ऑल्सो कि और मल्टीपल ब्रांच आउट होती है और धीरे धीरे यू टेंड टू स्पेशलाइज. एंड द बेस्ट पार्ट इज आई पर्सनली फील दैट लाइक आई वॉज ट्रैवलिंग टू इंडिया, आई कुड टेक केयर ऑफ माई वर्क. Why? Because I can carry this work anywhere. I can take it across borders. I need to meet, you know, after this COVID thing gets over, I need to do some seminars in Europe. I need to do some seminars in Dubai. And I will be attending those seminars. Why? Just because of the simple reason that this is all online. I can take it there. Until and unless it's a court hearing, judicial review application or anything. Then also these days it was online, so that's why I could take it. But now, otherwise this area of practice is remote working as well, so which is quite for me, person like me, I really like that. So for me it was quite an experience, and I think this area of law has a complete recognition as a lawyer. You need to expertise. In fact, the law societies are going to give you expert certificates after a few years of immigration practice, and they do recognize the law pro yahan pe jo lawyers ki insurance hai wo isko as a area of law recognize karke aapki insurance ko zyada ya kam karti hai us hisab se. So in all you can completely imagine that like any other stream of law that we've been doing in the past, this area of law also has a lot of scope. सो टुडे आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू डिस्कस दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक एंड इट वॉज ऑन माई माइंड बिकॉज बड़े सारे लोगों ने मुझसे ये बात पूछी हुई थी. सो वैन आई वॉज गोइंग थ्रू द मैसेजेस एंड आई डू हैव टू रिप्लाई टू अ लॉट ऑफ देम आई नो एंड आई विल बट जब आई वॉज गोइंग थ्रू दिस होल क्वेश्चन तो आई थॉट दैट येस आई शुड डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक बिकॉज नो बडी टेल्स यू अबाउट इट एक्चुअली कि इमिग्रेशन लॉ इज एक्चुअली अ लॉ लॉ एंड यू हैव टू एक्सपर्टाइज इन दैट एंड यू हैव टू रियली स्टडी हार्ड. देर आर लैंडमार्क केसेज इन दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया ऑफ लॉ. यू कैन गो थ्रू रीड थ्रू द बेकर केस, द वैल्यू ऑफ जजमेंट. ये सारी एडमिन की है, ये किसके अगेंस्ट है, ये सारी मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इमिग्रेशन एंड सिटीजनशिप डिपार्टमेंट की है. सो बेसिकली ऑल दिस यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड दैट इज वाई कलेक्टेड दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन फॉर यू टूडे. नाउ इफ यू हैव एनी अदर क्वेश्चन क्वेरी कंसर्न प्लीज पुट इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट गेट इन टच विद मी द डिटेल्स आर इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स रिलेटेड टू योर एनी काइंड ऑफ इमिग्रेशन मैटर विच और अदरवाइज इफ यू आर लिसनिंग टू मी एज अ फ्यूचर लॉयर और अ लॉ व्लॉग देन यू शुड नो दैट आई will be vlogging more in the recent times about laws and anything that you in particular that you want me to know besides the NCA, besides the law society, kyunki un sab pe main bahut sari videos bana chuki hu. If there's anything that is of your interest, please let me know. Do subscribe to my channel, like and share. Thank you. Bye bye.